Hello everyone, I'm Cason Rodriguez, Vice Principal of Milagres College, Mangalore. Today, I'm dealing with the topic, gratuity. Gratuity under Section 10, Subsection 10, is the amount paid by the employer to his employee on his retirement for leaving the job as a gratitude. So, in simple words, we are saying thank you in monetary terms for the valuable service rendered in the organization by him or her. So it is classified into two: if received while in service, it is fully taxable. Gratuity are classified into two: if received while in service, fully taxable. If received at the time of retirement, resignation or termination, for government employee it is fully exempt. I repeat, if it is received at the time of retirement, resignation or termination, for government employee it is fully exempt. Whereas non-government employee, it is again classified into two, that is covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972 and not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972. If you see Payment of Gratuity Act covered under the Act 1972, there are three conditions. So least of the following: the first one is actual gratuity received, second one is statutory limit 20 lakhs. So make a note here, for both covered and not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, first two conditions are same. There is no difference with the first two conditions. The first condition says actual gratuity received. The second condition says statutory limit, that is maximum limit is 20 lakhs. Whereas covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act and not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act, the third rule is different. There is a change in the third rule. The third rule says 15 divided 26 of monthly salary for every completed year of service or part of the year in excess of 6 months shall be taken as one full year. That means for example, 4 years and 9 months will be treated as 5 years, and 4 years and 5 months will be treated as 4 years itself. So please make a note, if it is 4 years, 6 months, 1 day, then it is considered to be the, will be treated as full next year, that will be 5 years. Whereas if it is 4 years, 5 months and 15 days, it is considered, it will be treated as 4 years itself. So make a note over there. So coming to the not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, the third rule says half month average salary for every completed year of service. Now what you mean by average salary? Average salary is nothing but it is average salary of last 10 months preceding the month of retirement must be considered. Now what you mean by preceding the month of retirement? That means, for example, if a person gets retired in the month of November, then preceding the month of retirement, that is November month, will not be taken into consideration. It will be from October, September, August up to January. 10 months we are supposed to consider. So January to October will be taken as 10 months, whereas the month where he gets retired will not be considered for calculation. So please see that there is a difference with the third condition. The third rule says for not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act, there is no part thereof exceeding 6 months. As I said previously, I told if a person is retiring in the month of November, so November month is ignored for the calculation. From October previously it is taken up to 10 months, that is January. So January to October it is 10 months, whereas in this for not covered under the Act, if it is 5 years, 9 months, if the problem states it is 5 years and 9 months, it is considered to be 5 years and it will not be taken as next full year. So I hope this is very clear. Now we are coming to the salary calculation. For covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act, salary means basic plus DA. So remember, your salary means plus DA. No other things will be considered for salary calculation. It is just basic and DA. Whereas not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, salary means basic plus DA. For DA, there is a clause. It says it should be considered for retirement benefit and plus commission, it should be fixed percentage turnover. So I repeat once again the entire thing. Gratuity, if received while in service, it is fully taxable. If received at the time of retirement, resignation or termination, it is classified into two again. Government employee, it is always exempt, whereas non-government employee, there are two categories covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972 and not covered under the Payment of Gratuity 2. The first two rules are same, actual gratuity received, statutory limit or maximum limit is 20 lakhs. Whereas third condition says 15 divided 26 of monthly salary for every completed years of service or part thereof exceeding 6 months. This is part thereof 6 months means if it is the service is rendered for 3 years, 6 months and 12 days, then it will be rounded off to the next year, that is the next full year, that will be 4 years. Whereas this is not applicable for not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act, that is under third condition, half month average salary for every completed year of service. Average salary of last 10 months preceding the month of retirement to be considered. So as I said with the example previously, I told if a person is retiring in the month of November, so November month will be ignored. You start your calculation from October to preceding 10 months up to January. So salary will be a calculation of salary for covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act. Salary will be basic plus DA. No other things will be considered for the calculation. Whereas not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act, salary will be basic DA if it is considered for retirement benefit, whereas commission, it will be fixed turnover. I hope there will be no doubts. Thank you.